Like I said, just came to visit for a minute, but y'all got enough people, so we're going to go share the gospel, you know, try to get some
sins. See, I was beat down in a gang when I was 14 and 15 years old, and Jesus showed me mercy when I repented and forsake my sins. I forsook my sins through the presence and power of the Holy Ghost through the name of Jesus Christ, and he showed me compassion. John chapter 8, Jesus showed the adulterous woman mercy, and he told her to sin no more. So God is commanding that everyone must repent. It is not an option, people. It is a commandment for salvation. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and if any man wishes to come to me, he must come to the Father. He must come by him. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ said, all who are weary and heavy laden, come unto me, and I will give you rest for your soul. I will give you rest for your soul. Come unto me and I will give you rest for your soul. The Bible says, do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. No fornicator, no drunkard, no drunkard person will inherit God's kingdom. No adulterous person will inherit God's kingdom. Are you going to go fornicate tonight, sir? Jesus can save you from that fornication. Hallelujah. And that God is angry with the wicked every day, but God can show you mercy when you forsake your sin. When you call on the name of Jesus Christ, he will give you salvation when you repent and believe. You have to repent and believe to receive the salvation that comes from Jesus Christ. If you want compassion from the Father, you must repent and forsake your sin. Jesus Christ said, everyone that does not repent shall all likewise perish.
Hallelujah. That was a good word from the Holy Ghost. Wicked.
Drunkards will not inherit the kingdom of heaven. The problem being that many of you believe foolishly, you believe foolishly that you can go on. You think that you're not drunkards because you don't go to an AA meeting and sit around and cry and talk about your alcoholism. But the Bible doesn't really mean a drunkard like that. It means if you've been waiting all week long till Friday and Saturday night to come, and the only thing you've been looking forward to is that drink of vodka, you are a drunkard. That's where you get your rest. And when you find when you come before God, you're going to find out that you've been serving an idol. Yes, that whiskey, that vodka that you've been thinking about all week long is your idol. Yes, you don't want the rest that God offered you. That takes too much. You have to come before God holy. You have to come before God broken. That takes too much. It's easier to buy a shot. It's easier to buy a beer. It's easier to go down to the project and get you a little bag of drugs. It's easier to do all those things than to come broken before God.